Hi, I'm Dr. Andrea Pennington, and I know what you're going through. As a medical professional, I've been working with pregnant women for several years, and I'm pleased to be talking to you today on behalf of the Food and Drug Administration. These 9 months can be an exciting time, but prepare yourself. Everyone from your favorite aunt to the local bus driver is going to be giving you advice. Welcome to the wonderful world of pregnancy. Now we have one more issue that as a pregnant woman you need to know about. Toxoplasmosis.
Toxoplasmosis in pregnancy. I have no idea what that is. Is that related to the cat litter? I only heard about don't change the cat litter while you're pregnant.
Do I have to give up my cat?
One of my best friends had the same fear about toxoplasmosis, but thankfully she didn't have to part with her beloved cat. It just meant she had to pay attention to a few rules. So what exactly is the link between toxoplasmosis and cats? And how do you get it?
Toxoplasmosis is an illness caused by the parasite Toxoplasma gondii. More than 60 million people in the United States carry the parasite, but very few have symptoms because our immune system keeps the parasite dormant and unable to cause illness. Toxoplasmosis can be difficult to detect. However, symptoms typically include swollen glands, fever, headache, muscle pain, or a stiff neck. If you experience any of these symptoms, you should see your healthcare provider immediately. In general, expectant mothers should be cautious because toxoplasma infection just before or during pregnancy can cause problems for their unborn babies. As cute as they are, it's true that cats and kittens are the most common carriers of Toxoplasma gondii.
If you're a cat lover, it's understandable that you should be concerned for your baby. One very simple step you can take is to have someone else change the litter box if possible, like your husband, another adult, or a responsible person like an older child. If you must change it yourself, wear disposable gloves and wash your hands thoroughly with soap and warm water afterwards. So, this is a case where clean is critical.
Cats become carriers by eating rodents, birds, or other small animals that have been infected by Toxoplasma gondii, and the parasite is then spread through the cat feces. So soil, litter boxes, sand boxes, and any place where cat feces can be found should be avoided by pregnant women.
Cat lovers, follow these tips to reduce your risk of exposing yourself to Toxoplasma. Change the litter box daily. The parasite does not become infectious until 1 to 5 days after it is shed in the feces. Feed your cat commercial dry or canned food. Don't feed your cat raw meat or table scraps. Cover your outdoor sandboxes. And keep indoor cats indoors.
Toxoplasmosis can also be spread through animals such as pigs, sheep, and deer. You can become infected by eating undercooked pork, lamb, or venison, or by handling the raw meat and not washing your hands afterwards. The risk of toxoplasmosis is another reason why it's extremely important to cook meats to proper temperatures.
For more information on food safety during your pregnancy, visit the FDA website as shown on your screen. I'm Dr. Andrea Pennington, wishing you a happy, healthy pregnancy.